Learning a new language doesn't have to be a part of a high school or college curriculum. The students don't even have to sit at home practicing with their Rosetta Stone. They're learning Finnish in the best way possible, in a classroom setting with other students. Teacher Tanya Stanaway has been teaching Yoopers Finnish for almost 40 years.
Well, it was 1979 when I approached the school system and asked that I noticed there were a lot of Finnish people around. I wonder if they would like to learn to speak Finnish.
Reluctantly, the Nagani school system agreed. There's no way this will work, they said. But that Monday in September,
63 people showed up in a classroom.
Safe to say that Finns and others were more than interested in learning about the language and heritage that built Michigan's Upper Peninsula. Many are keen on keeping it around.
You know, our culture, I think it's really important to preserve it. We've come a long way, and it'd be a shame to lose what we've built.
15 students spend a couple of hours every week honing their skills and keeping that culture alive. It's not the easiest language to learn, yet every week they're back with their homework done, eager to learn.
The main thing I just learned is how difficult the language really is once you actually try to learn it and speak it properly.
It sure is difficult. The following is one whole word.
Lentokone suihku turbiini moottori apu mekaanikko aliupseeri oppilas.
If students have trouble pronouncing that word or anything else, they can reach Tanya at any time.
They can call me. I always say that call me, I like to talk. So then if they have a question to translate the sentence or something, they don't have to wait till next week.
The class was very kind and welcoming, but they wouldn't let me leave until I pronounced sauna correctly. Clearly, I have a lot to learn. For the record, the correct pronunciation is sauna. In Nagani, I'm Kellen Buddy, reporting for ABC 10 and the CW5.